A very good morning to students. In previous video, we had studied about the basic versus applied psychology and the different disciplines and the psychology, the relationship between different disciplines and psychology. Okay, and the different fields of applied psychology where psychologists can work. And in this video, we will cover the last topic of the chapter 1, which is psychology in everyday life. That means the importance of psychology in day-to-day life, how psychology helps us in our daily life. Okay, so now look at the concept. The discussion above may have clarified that psychology is not only a subject that satisfied some of the curiosity of our mind about human nature, because psychology is a study of human nature, and it satisfied our curiosities about human life or human nature. But it is also a subject that can offer solution to a variety of problems, and these may range from purely personal. For example, a daughter having to face an alcoholic father, or a mother dealing with a problematic child or problem child, and to those that may be rooted within the family setup. For example, lack of communication and interactions among family members, or in a larger group or community setting. For example, terrorist group or socially isolated communities. That means psychologist or psychology help us to understand individuals' relationship as well as individuals' relationship with their societies, with their families, with their relatives. Okay, so it works on both level. In an individual level, the person's memory, person's personality, person's intelligence, as well as the social connections. Connections between two countries, connections between the two communities, the relationship between the individual and the society, the relationship between the family members amongst them. So these are the content material of psychology. So it works on both levels, or may have national or international dimensions. It has also worked on national and international dimensions. Problems related to education, health, environment, social justice, women development, intergroup relationship or intergroup conflict, etc. That means psychology work in almost all the field where human nature are assessed. And psychology is pervasive, while the solution of these problems may involve political, economical and social reforms. So in this way, psychology helps us to political, economic and social reforms. And interventions at the individual level are also needed in order to change. Many of these problems are largely of psychological nature, and they result from our unhealthy thinking, negative attitudes toward people and self and undesirable patterns of behavior. So that means these type of problems which are generated, for example, political problem, economical problem or social problems, these are only due to our unhealthy thinking, our maladjustive pattern of our behavior, and this is basically our negative attitude. Okay, so these are the reason of all type of problems, or type of origin of the problems. A psychological analysis of these problems helps both in having a deeper understanding of these problems and also in finding their effective solutions. So that means psychological information, the knowledge of this discipline, is help us to understand the complexity or the basic concept of these problems, and as well as the solution of these problems. Okay, as well as the effective solution of these problems. So the potential of psychology in solving the problems of life is being realized more and more. Nowadays, जैसे जैसे सब्जेक्ट का डेवलपमेंट हो रहा है, द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ साइकोलॉजी इज ऑल्सो इंक्रीज्ड. द डिमांड ऑफ साइकोलॉजी इन डे टू डे लाइफ इज इंक्रीज्ड. ओके, सो मीडिया हैज प्लेड अ वाइटल रोल इन दिस दिस रिस्पेक्ट और दिस पर्सपेक्टिव. यू मे हैव सीन ऑन टेलीविजन काउंसलर्स एंड थेरेपिस्ट सजेस्ट सल्यूशन टू अ वराइटी ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स रिलेटेड टू चिल्ड्रंस, adolescents, adults and the elderly peoples. So media plays a important role in psychological field. The awareness, media ka jo work hai basically awareness mein hai. Psychologist ka kya role hai, how it helps the human beings, ye sare ke bare mein ek information dena, ye media ka role hai aur ye media is plays a their role. You may also find them analyzing vital social problems related to social change and development and population, poverty, interpersonal and intergroup violence and environmental degradation. Many psychologists now play an active role in designing and executing interventions programs in order to provide people with a better quality of life. Hence, it is no surprise that we find psychologists working in a diverse settings such as schools, hospitals, industries, prisons and business organizations, military establishment and in private practices also. And as consultant helping people solve their problems in their respective settings. So that means the psychologist helps people in a different settings in their different problems. So besides helping you in rendering social service to others, the knowledge of psychology is also personally relevant to you in your day-to-day life. The knowledge of this discipline is very important for your day-to-day life, for managing your day-to-day life. Okay, so the principles and the methods of psychology that you will learn in this course should be made use of in analyzing and understanding yourself in relation to other. And it is not that we do not think about ourselves, but very often some of us think very highly of ourselves, and any feedback that contradict our opinion about ourselves is rejected. So because we engage in what is called a defense behavior, in later on you can study about the defense behavior or defense mechanism. So in some other cases, persons come to acquire a habit of running down themselves. Both conditions do not permit us to grow. We need to have a positive and balanced understanding of ourselves. So in this, you may use psychological principle in a positive manner to develop good habits of study, for improving your learning and memory, and for solving your personal and interpersonal problems by using appropriate decision making strategies. And you will also find it of use to reduce or alleviate the stress of examination. And thus the knowledge of psychology is quite useful in our everyday life and is rewarding from personal as well as social point of view. Okay. Nowadays you can see after the Sushant case and after the COVID-19, there are so many awareness programs given by psychologists. There are so much information given by psychologists in their societies and a personal level pe also. Okay, in personal level pe or in a community level pe, social level pe bhi is tarah ki awareness programs chalaye ja rahe hain, jisse COVID-19 se related jo bhi stress hai, jo bhi problems hain, वो सॉर्ट आउट हो जाए. ड्यू टू क्योंकि एक वर्किंग जो कल्चर था हमारा, जो वर्किंग सेटिंग था, उससे काफ़ी चेंजेस आ गए अभी. ओके, सो नाउ अडेज So you can see in these days the importance of psychology is very much increasing because the demand of psychology is increasing. क्योंकि स्ट्रेस और एनजाइटी अभी के सिचुएशन में इतना ज़्यादा इंक्रीज हो रहा है ड्यू टू COVID-19 और ड्यू टू सुसाइडल टेंडेंसीज, ड्यू टू एनजाइटी, स्ट्रेस. सो इन सारे फैक्टर्स की वजह से साइकोलॉजिस्ट की नीड दिन ब दिन इंक्रीज हो जा रही है. दैट्स मीन द नॉलेज ऑफ साइकोलॉजी इज वेरी मच बेनिफिशियल फॉर अस फॉर अंडरस्टैंडिंग अवर सेल्फ ऑल्सो एंड द अंडरस्टैंडिंग द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द अदर्स पीपल एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग अदर पीपल्स ऑल्सो. दैट ओके. सो साइकोलॉजी इज अ वॉट? साइकोलॉजी इज अ बेसिकली स्टडी अबाउट द ह्यूमन नेचर. इट इज अ साइंटिफिक स्टडी ऑफ ह्यूमन माइंड एंड ह्यूमन बिहेवियर. सो साइकोलॉजी इज वेरी हेल्पफुल इन अवर ओवर अ डे टू डे लाइफ. In which extent? So there is a some point. There is a 5 point in which we understand the role of psychology in our day-to-day life. So first of all, psychology ki knowledge se kya help milta hai? First of all, improving communication. If you have knowledge of psychology, if you know this subject of psychology, you can definitely improve your communication skills because psychology makes it easier to understand how human thinks and behave while communicating with others. So how psychology improve our communication skill? Let's see. Psychology makes it easier to understand how human thinks, how human beings are thinking and behaving. So while communicating with others with the help of psychological knowledge, people can comprehend gestures and postures and their actions, so which would make communication even easier. Okay, when we know about the gestures and the posture of the individual, then you can easily comprehend the message which someone asked to share with you. Okay, so in this way psychology is help in our improving our communication skills. This is known as non-verbal communication. Okay, so in understanding the non-verbal communication of human beings, psychology is help us. Okay, now second is building relationship. With the help of psychological knowledge, definitely the relationship is improving and the bonding of relationship is enhanced and stronger. How? As we already know, the psychology is the study of human mind and behavior. Psychology plays a major role in understanding human actions, so thereby fostering relationship. If you know the human behavior effectively, if you understand the human behavior, you can definitely use it in building relationships. Now, second is enriching careers. How? So psychology helps people to understand others and establish friendship and relationship. If you have a good communication skill, if you are easily create or develop a relationship with someone, so this is definitely help in your career. Okay, so it is helping in your friendship and relationship with peoples, and having a psychological ideas would stand a better chance to build friendship with their co-workers. Okay, the relationship of your co-workers and the relationship between you and your boss or your authority persons or with your administration, it is definitely helps in your career, in your career growth. Next is instill self-confidence. If you know the psychology well, it is definitely help in building your self-confidence. It is helping enhancing your self-confidence. One can gain self-confidence by learning and knowing more about oneself. ठीक है, self-confidence किसके थ्रू आता है? The information about your own feelings, about your own skills, about your own potential attributes. So if you know yourself better, your confidence will automatically high and your confidence is high by learning and knowing more about oneself and their personality. If you know your personality and or if someone's personality is definitely help you. So psychology help us in understanding our strength and as well as our weaknesses. So it helps in developing self-confidence, developing relationship and even so many other areas. And next is psychology is given us an insight. Insight that means cognition, which help us to know about you, yourself and help us to understand world better. So I can gain insight into people's behavior. Psychology tell us about all aspects of human behavior. It not only tells us about general human characters, characteristics, but also points out different differences their behavior. And clinical psychologist especially helps to gain insight into other people's behavior. So that means psychology is very helpful in our day-to-day life. It helps us in a communication and enhancing our self-confidence, in understanding our personality, and in understanding why some people are very weak, why some people are very much intelligent, why which career is very much suitable for us, my skills, which kind of skills I have, and which kind of job is very much suitable for us. And it helps in building relationships, in good good understanding of people's, in adjustment. So that means psychology is help in almost all area of human behavior where psychology is helping. Okay, students, so this is all about chapter 1. Today your chapter 1 what is psychology is completed. So in this we psychology, let's revise the whole chapter. So there is a concept of psychology. So what is psychology? Psychology is a study of human nature, or human nature, mental processes, experiences and behavior in a different cultural context. Okay, in this there are four concept: mental processes, behavior, experiences and a different context. So mental process, what is mental process? Mental process is something which we can known as our consciousness. Mental process is basically our building blocks, which is a basic unit of our thinking, our memorizing, our reasoning, our problem solving ability. So this is known as our mental processes. Now experiences are subjective in nature, which is very much subjective. And in behavior are any response or reaction which anybody can do. And this is basically in psychology we can study about the SR relationship behavior. We can study about behavior in a terms of SR relationship, that means stimulus response relationship. And when we are talking about the context, this is basically our social or cultural context. Okay, after that, psychology as a discipline. So there is a question: psychology is a which kind of discipline? Is a science or a social science? There is a two type of science. So psychology is a basically a science, because in 1879 when the William Wundt was established our first laboratory in Leipzig, so वहाँ से start हुआ था psychology का as a science journey. So psychology is very much a science. It is a natural science or social science, this is a topic of debate. So psychology is a natural science because it's used the scientific method for studying the behavior. And there is a variability, there is a reliability, there is a verification, standardization, they are finding a cause and effect relationship. The conclusion are very much generalized with the to the peoples, and that's why we can say it is a natural science. Psychology as a social science because human beings are social animals, or human beings are social in nature. That's why we can study human behavior in a social or cultural context. We study the human behavior in a social context. That's why we can say psychology is a social science. The content material and the technique both are prove that the psychology is a natural or social science. Okay, now another concept in this chapter is a mind and behavior. This is a very interesting topic. So mind and behavior, how it is correlated? We can already study about the mind and brain. Mind is a function and brain is a structure. Okay, so how mind is influence our behavior. So many studies, so many researches are proven that ki mind is control our behavior or influence our behavior. That means the relationship between mind and behavior is very strong. If our mind is healthy, our behavior is shown that. Okay, now popular notions about the discipline of psychology, which is basically जो myths है psychology को लेके, वो जो generally जो terms चले आ रहे हैं, जो बातें society में exist कर रही हैं कि जो कि ऐसा होता है, वो basically it is a stereotype or it is a based on our experiences, it is a based on our elder people's, which can say, okay, so this is basically that and different. It is how different through the psychology. So this is the topic of popular notion about the discipline of psychology. यहाँ पे बहुत सारे points हमने discuss किए, जहाँ पे हमने clearly बताया कि psychology use a scientific method to study the behavior. It if psychology अगर कुछ कह रही है तो उसको वो proof कर रही है, ठीक है, वो उसको verify कर रही है. But popular notions से जो conclusion निकल के आ रहे हैं या कोई अगर fact आ रहा है तो it may be or it may be not effective, it may be or it may be not proven. Okay, so this is all about now evolution of psychology. So in evolution of psychology, we had studied about the five or six schools of psychology. Basically, when we are talking about the world level evolution of psychology, world history. When we see the world history, there is some schools of psychology. For example, first school by by William Wundt, which is a structuralism, which used the technique of introspection, and after that functionalism given by William James. उसके बाद gestalt psychology. Gestalt psychology is basically talking importance of whole. That means the whole is more important than the part of or some of the parts. Okay, then behaviorism given by Watson, and here we talk about the Skinner's work. Okay, and psychoanalysis given by Freud. Ke baad humanistic perspective, here we can talk about Rosers, Abraham Maslow's. Okay, so these are the psychologists who work in this field. Uske baad cognitive perspective, which is as it comparison to the information processing approach, which compared the human brain in the computer, and so many other. After that, development of psychology in India, where the first work by S.N. Sen Gupta in Kolkata University, जहाँ पे उन्होंने experimental psychology को firstly introduce किया, and वो हमने understand किया. After that, themes of research and application. So there are so many themes, basically the five thing: psychology is a science, and psychology is always work with a cause. First themes tell about the psychology is a study of mental process and behavior, as it is other sciences ye bhi research karti hai and develop some principles and some theories. Second themes is tell us about the human behavior is a function of attributes, the human, the person's attribute and the characteristic of environment or the effect of environment. So this is our second theme. Third theme is human behavior is cause. So every human behavior के पीछे जो होता है वो एक cause होता है. After that, understanding of human behavior in culturally constructed way में. That means culture is play an important role in understanding of human behavior. And after that, fifth or last theme is human behavior can be controlled and modified, and the principles of basic psychology can apply in real life setting, and it helps us. And after themes of research and application, there is a topic of psychology and other discipline. Here we can understand the correlation between the psychology and the other disciplines. So there are so many disciplines which can be connected with psychology. For example, education, economics, political science, philosophy, music and fine arts, law, criminology, mass communication, sociology, computer science, medicine, neuropsychology, and architecture and engineering, and philosophy, and so many other disciplines which are connected with the psychology. And I think I missed a topic, branches of psychology. Okay, so branches of psychology here, where the different branches are psychology. So basically branches of psychology, that's mean cognitive psychology, biological psychology, and neurological psychology, and social psychology, cross-cultural and cultural psychology, environmental psychology, health psychology, clinical and counseling psychology, industrial and organizational psychology, educational psychology, and sports psychology, and so many other emerging branches which are new, okay, in which maybe military psychology, women's psychology, and engineering psychology, paramedical psychology, so many, forensic psychology, these are the new branches of psychology. And after that, psychology at work, psychologist at work. Before this topic, we can understand the concept of basic psychology and the applied psychology. We can discriminate between these two. So basic psychology and applied psychology. What is applied psychology? The principles and theories which develop or which can originate in a basic psychology. In applied psychology, the same principle and the same theory can be applicable or applied in so many situations or so many streams of in human behaviors. This is the this is our applied psychology. In this we can understand the different applied aspects or applied fields where the psychologists are work, basically clinical, counseling, school, industrial setting, and last one is school psychology. Okay, community psychology. So basically clinical psychologist, counseling psychologist, community psychologist, school psychologist, and organizational or industrial psychologist. So these are the five fields where psychologists are working. And psychology in everyday life, in this part we had understand the importance of psychology in everyday life, how psychology is important for us, and how it help us in improving our life quality and how it's work with us. Okay, so this is all about first chapter. And in homework, students, aapko karna kya hai ki ek टी डायग्राम और एक जस्ट एक समरी टाइप का बनाना है आपको पूरा चैप्टर वन का. ठीक है, द होल चैप्टर इज कवरिंग इन ओनली इन अ वन पेज. अंडरस्टैंड? सो अ माइंड मैप और अ ट्री फॉर चैप्टर वन, द ऑल द इम्पॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट एंड ऑल द बेसिक डेफिनेशन ऑफ द कॉन्सेप्ट और द मीनिंग ऑफ द कॉन्सेप्ट आर इंक्लूडेड इन दैट डायग्राम. अंडरस्टैंड? दिस इज योर होमवर्क. ओके, actually this is your first chapter. This is only a basic which you help to understand the subject, the discipline ki psychology hai kaisa, how it is. And so little bit aapko difficulty hogi iske jo concepts hain, jo definitions hain, jo basically jo psychologist ke name hain unhe remember rakhne mein aapko kafi difficulty hogi. But don't worry, टेंशन लेने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. रीड अगेन एंड अगेन, यू कैन डेफिनेटली एबल टू रिमेंबर द नेम्स एंड रिमेंबर एंड अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट ईजिली. सो डोंट बी सो मच पैनिक और सो मच टेकिंग नॉट सो मच स्ट्रेस. ओके, दिस इज़ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एंड ईजी सब्जेक्ट. ओके, सो जस्ट रीड अगेन एंड अगेन. ओके, बिकॉज दिस इज़ वेरी न्यू सब्जेक्ट, द कॉन्सेप्ट आर वेरी मच डिफरेंट टू अदर डिसिप्लिन्स. So you can take in some time to understand the concepts of psychology. Okay, so this is only the introduction of introductory session of the psychology. Okay, after that there is a 8 more chapters which we will discuss in later class. And very important thing, students, please make a fair copy where you can show me your homeworks. and in this section you can explain the concepts, and after that the question answer part. Okay, so in next video we will be discuss about the question answer. So we will understand the chapter for exam point of view. Okay, class, this is all about today's video. Thank you so much.